They got a lot right now, the girl DJ Black Barrier live inside the building. And of course, I have to say, big shout out to Radio Lan, because our special guest today is Jamaica's Dance All artist. She is the queen of dance hall. She's an entrepreneur, Grammy nominated, and she is back right here on One Love Radio. Spice, how you doing?
Wagwan. Thank you so much for having me.
It is definitely a pleasure, of course, to have you back on One Love Radio. You know, the thing said, you are a vibe. And of course, it is definitely an honor to have you back. And there is so much to talk about when it comes to your music career, because you know, say you're a topic, you're always on everybody's tongue. And it's not a topic for the town, you know, it's a topic for the entire world. And girl, I have to say, I love this for you nonetheless. But we have a jump in on this video right now that is making its round right now, Spice. The pop the balloon love game. Oh my gosh.
I have an ex-boyfriend and I'm looking for a next boyfriend.
Right. And boy, we have to say, little man, did you expect that from little man? Because little man, I go on.
You ever seen a speechless yet? Barbie, you want to see years. You ever seen a speechless?
Never.
I can't find the way I'm confused and shocked. I'm still speechless.
Oh my God. I'm strong still, you know. I'm strong.
Me, I'm over 200 pounds.
You don't look it, sir. You don't look it. But I have to say, him go out with himself, you know, him have a whole big talk. And the world, may I have to ask the world, you know, did he get a shot? Will he get a shot? Will he get a date? Or it's a big no? Can you say you're like feeling all over the house? So how is that now?
Him still trying. I'm going to think about it. I've never dated anyone on his height.
Mm-hmm.
But then a man, you know what he is, might as well try something new. So you never know what can happen.
Most definitely. And we know that was part one, so I'm sure part two is going to be crazy, right?
Yes, it is. It is.
Okay. So just to ask that question, is Spice dating right now, or is she just still on the search for Mr. Right?
Single and ready to mingle. You know, you ever say I have an ex-boyfriend, I'm looking for a next boyfriend. The thing is real.
Facts. I love that. All right. So big shout out, of course, to my Leo sis. And speaking, your birthday is right around the corner. Do you have anything special planned for your birthday?
This birthday is the only day I'm going to rest and don't work, because I've been working for every single day, as far back as I can remember for the year. So I told myself this birthday I'm just going to relax. I just take that day for myself. It's the only day I'm not going to work.
Oh, nice. You definitely deserve it, because you are booked and busy without
adults.
So are you currently still taping for Love and Hip Hop right now, or did you guys wrap production?
Well, we're currently still taping. Actually, I went to Unruly Fest and they came with me to cover that entire trip to England. So big up to the entire Love and Hip Hop cast that came out. Actually, to give you a little scoop on what's going on, I'm actually producing a Love and Hip Hop Atlanta cast album. So that's what's happening this season. So I record some of my cast member and I'm going to compile an album together. So you never know who's going to make it to this album, but the album is called Cyphers of the A, but it's going to be crazy.
Oh my God, you know, you're an entrepreneur. You always have the good idea. I think this is going to be epic. That is a brilliant idea, because you got so many like talents on Love and Hip Hop, and for you to be the one producing this, it's going to be epic. Well, boy, I would tell you, there's so many different personalities. I mean, how is production going so far, you know, with everyone trying to see who's going to make the cut?
It's crazy. I can't get too much tea. You have to watch this show, but I want one of my problems, and I'm worried for things, man. It's like, I'm telling everybody's not going to make the album. Because, you know, once me stamp me spicy and panic, it's not so good. And to be honest, you know, in all honesty, and all of them can rap, so.
Jesus! Spice! Let me try them thing, right?
What's the thing I know? Who's going to really make this album?
Man. So, of course, you guys definitely stay connected. Make sure that you watch Love and Hip Hop. It airs on MTV. And we're going to give you guys a scoop, but of course, it's going to be playing out on Love and Hip Hop. But once it drops, we're going to make it an announcement, so you guys could definitely go and check it out. And again, just in case you're just tuning into One Love Radio, we have a live on the phone line with us right now, Grammy nominated the dancehall queen, Spice herself. And taking it right back to the Unruly Fest. But not to no lie, it's like you got the biggest forward of that event, and you have to give us the backstory, because you know, in your speech to the crowd, you mentioned, you know, and you dropped the Vybz Kartel to Free Vybz Kartel. But take us back to what exactly happened to make you make that speech to the patrons.
I mean, we already know that it's going to be strict and tight, because we get the heads up from everyone. Mm-hmm. But even when your people are currently banded and there's no issue, it's like police, them just an extra work, or them a look for a reason to have a problem. And it's like, I'm like, we're not resisting for you to search the van or the vehicle. I had my own Sprinter and wrap with my album cover. So they knew the vehicle that I was in, but it was just like they want to dig up everything, they want to go through makeup, my guy. I understand, so now doing the work, but I had it all my extra needs.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, me just come look for makeup and come look for something for love. But I have to kill up on myself. Me not crazy, me not going to fight, but do nothing problem. I have to score the world. So I was just telling them, no, it's okay, you can come in, you can search whatever, but they just feel, I think they're over the edge, or they have this expectation. You know, you know, when the police just already expect to find something, I think they were giving that kind of vibe.
Man, I'm not saying like you get the biggest forward. Of course, you are always champion for the freedom of Vybz Kartel. And speaking of that same clip, you know, he reposted obviously on his Instagram page. But the highlight of all highlights is the fact that, of course, now he is a free man and he is out. And your video, when you actually lost your voice, so just take us through that moment when you found out that Mideya be a champion feed for free, and then now finally he is free. Take us back to that moment for your fans.
Listen, Black Barbie, I don't think they have words to express how happy I am for him to be out, finally freedom. To be honest, I've been chanting free Vybz Kartel, free world boss for the past 13 years. Everywhere we go, in a real town, everywhere, Kribik and Kana, anywhere we go tour, we make sure that the people then remind them of it, free the world boss. So the chanting that for 13 years has been land out of our flight and here taking outside. Yo, we run to the airport, it's them people crazy. You're watching me at the airport, I run and I scream. Like, I couldn't, like, it's so much joy. I'm happy that he's home with his family. And I'm just elated over the whole thing. It's a lot of joy right now. We still are celebrating. It's a birthday present to me, getting up on my birthday at Tuesday. Mm-hmm. So there's no sense a birthday present to me.
Without a doubt. And of course, you know, he's been like a mentor for you with your music career. You guys have multiple hits on top of hits. You know, and I know this is probably just jumping ahead, but can we actually expect a collaboration? Because he expresses love for you all the time. Like, he's, you know, how can I not love this woman? Because, you know, yes, you're always championing for him. So I'm guessing we can probably expect a collab. You know, sometimes
anything, you never know. Just want to listen up to some great music. You know, the king and the queen is always going to give you some great music.
Mad.
You never know what's going to happen.
Mad. And of course, we definitely can't wait. And you always put out amazing, amazing singles, hit singles. And right now, you have a project that is set to drop August the 9th, your album, Mirror 25. Tell us, for all right now, everybody, you guys could definitely get it on pre-order. But can you tell us, the fans, what they could actually expect on Mirror 25?
Mirror 25 is celebrating 25 years, because, you know, I've been in the business from 1999.
Mm-hmm.
So this is really just mirroring my 25 years in a dance hall. And this project has 25 songs to celebrate 25 years. I've already been releasing some of the singles from the album. Mm-hmm. It was dropped Round Round featuring Buster and the Boss Man. And everybody there fan, That just make you want to dance. I also dropped something from Chronic Law called Gangsta. That song is up. Make sure you're up to date, you know, Barbie. Make sure you have the new song then.
Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Boo.
I
do.
Gangsta with Chronic Law. And recently, I just dropped Ex-Boyfriend, which is why you saw the Pop the Balloon Challenge, because I'm really searching for the next boyfriend. The Ex-Boyfriend is out, it's like the new anthem for the girl them right now. Because I'm even talk to the man, they're not being themselves, they're not going good. Every girl I'm talking to, them have an Ex-Boyfriend. So what's going on? So that the man, them, they don't decide to stop cheating. The girl and I go come, but they just behave themselves.
Never. There is no behavior when it comes to men. I'm so sorry. And we're not going to accept it still enough, so we don't need to get the thing together still then. But speaking about the single Ex-Boyfriend, the music video is currently out. Make sure that you guys definitely go and check it out on her Vivo channel. But not telling no lie, the music video art, it's spicy. But spice, there is a little talk when it comes to the music video that certain ex-men resemble. You know, when we're not going to say no name,
you
resemble.
Nobody
would tell me. What do y'all say? Certain X-Men resemble an X-Men of yours. And we just want to know, is this purposefully that you did it? Because we see that it's a young and upcoming artist that is featured in the music video. But the resemblance is like, oh my God, Spice. So tell us. Tell us the reason behind the selection of this cameo appearance of this young man that looked like somebody that's a Ross.
You know what, to be honest, when I was doing the song and thinking about the Ex-Boyfriend and I reached out to the director, I wanted him to make it as real as possible. You know me, I always have a problem with the creativity.
True.
And I do have an Ex-Boyfriend, which everybody knows. It's not no secret. We have a very public relationship. Everybody knows that he's our ex. So when I met this person who is Rocky, he's also an artist from Jamaica. But couldn't stop looking at him. Come here, say, this one man could have really resemble one man. So. And I was the one who kind of approached him and said, if I'm shooting a video called Ex-Boyfriend, you look like my ex-boyfriend. I wanted to be this to see it. And he's like, really? And I was just only calling him on and that's chilling, but that's the one I called the Rasta man. He said, yes, you feel bad about it. And he was like, yes, I'll do it. And that was it.
But yes, in favor, but I was like, wait, I had to do a double take. Like, oh wait, did Spice get back together? Like, what's going on? You know? Well, I was like, wow. But I love this because, so the Ex-Boyfriend song is about him, or are you just a single ex in a general?
Some of it, but I'm thinking about ex in general.
In general, okay. All right. Make sure that you guys definitely go and check it out. We still have so much more to talk about with the one and only Grammy-nominated dancehall queen, Spice. She's live on the phone line with us right now. The interview is definitely not over, but we're going to check out one of her latest singles off the album, Mirror 25. Again, make sure you definitely go and pre-order it. It's dropping August the 9th. And right now, we're going to check out what? Ex-Boyfriend. Yes, because you're going to get the next one. Write us up on One Love Radio. Keep where you got it.
Why, oh, why, oh, why? Shut up to the ground!
Why do men give us this feeling? I'm really not sure. You say you want trust, but you do some things to make me unsure. I'm confident in myself.
I beg to
just that you put in my head make me feel insecure. Why, oh, why, oh, why?
You wanted me, you got me, then you turn around and now you lost. Now sit down in a no man misery, no boy can disrespect me. Before we start
hitting,
tell you that's just not gonna be late. I don't communicate, you don't appreciate the love turn to hate. I know you want talk, but it's too late. Now I got another ex-boyfriend. I got another
ex-boyfriend, and she's looking for a next boyfriend. Again, make sure that you guys definitely go and check out this single and pre-order the album Mirror 25. Boy, I'm not telling a lie, I love this song. It's like an anthem because, you know, a whole heap of girl can relate to this, because as you hear, man love cheat and we're not gonna sit on it. So we're gonna just leave the ex and find a next. And I definitely love this single. But I'm not telling a lie, Spice, you come out with the vocals. You come up with the vocals on this track.
Thank you so much. I mean, our entire album is very diverse. And so I know that a lot of people will enjoy it because it's like so many different sounds and I'm playing with different things that they don't normally hear me, you know, in a certain way. So thank you so much. I'm loving this ex-boyfriend song for real. Like everybody just been telling me how much they love it. So
yeah, it's a vibe. It's definitely a vibe. And you know, we can't sing it, especially for all the single man about it. Or the one who left them on. Yeah, we can definitely relate to this one. And you know, speaking about earlier, you know, you mentioned you have the single Gangsta with Chronic Law. Can you tell us what was that like, you know, when you guys, you decided, of course, to do this collaboration with him, and what was that working relationship like?
Well, the relationship is great. I want to say, we've been in studio together, but we never record this song together. You did his part and I did my part. Because our schedule is always clashing, and it's why people are coming to see a music video right now, and I don't have the music video because it's like, every time you miss someone, needed somewhere. But he did his part, I sent me back the track, and then I still in my part, and it was just like, you know, a movie, because we have similar fan base, so we know the thing when it comes to the streets and what they want.
Most definitely. And speaking about that song, obviously, because we are promoting the album Mirror 25, we're just gonna give you guys a little taste, not too much of it, because of course we want you guys to definitely go and pre-order. All right, so we're gonna drop this one. It's Fights featuring Chronic Law, and it's Gangsta. Cause she's about to go right. That's about One Love Radio. Gangsters, Gangsta. Make sure that you guys again pre-order the album. Pre-order it right now. Yes, that is Spice featuring Chronic Law. So I have to say, Spice, after our last interview, a lot have definitely happened. We know that you are definitely, you know, you and Busta Rhymes have, I feel like, the best relationship ever. You know, it's just something great to see. And I have to say, big congratulations, and you definitely did your thing when it came to that BET performance. You know, because that happened, you know, right after our interview, which was just amazing. It was amazing to actually see. And you, you know, and other one of, you know, our rest of our Jamaican artists represent. Can you tell us what was that like to hit the big BET stage?
Oh, that was like, I was so elated to perform that day because they was also awarding Busta Rhymes for his journey in music. We're always representing dancehall in an authentic way. It was a pleasure for me. I remember when I went there and I did my performance, a lot of people thought I should have performed a different way. What they don't realize is that you have to do a rehearsal to perform, and your performance, the song, everything has to be approved, that this is national television. So when people was like, oh, my friends have to do this or that, I'm like, it just reminds me of the fight with dancehall still, I guess. Mm-hmm. And that people don't even realize that I'm always going to be authentic to the genre. I mean, I'll change and watch it on my team. No time at all to please nobody. But that performance, it was a memory for me, because I think that was my first, second time ever performed. But it was just a big moment for me performing on BET. And we have to big up for setting that precedent.
Yes, without a doubt. Big, big shout out to Busta. Like we said, you know, he's our Jamaican brother who always represents, you know, the Jamaican culture, which we appreciate. And we like the fact, as you say, you know, go water down who you are, because you are representing us on an international level, on the international market. And it's good to see you just staying true to yourself, because a lot of times people feel like they need to, you know, get too commercialized and not show the real authentic Jamaican. And that's what the culture, which is what bring you to that platform and what people loved about you to begin with, that you don't want to lose your authenticity at the same time. But big shout out to you. I know people is always talking, and speaking about people always talking, you, the first single that you drop off Mirror 25, which is the 2085 T, that created a lot of, what would I say, controversy in the dancehall scene. Did you actually expect when releasing that single it was gonna do what it actually did and created so much, what would I say, people having everything to say when it comes to you and, you know, whatever past experience and relationship that happened, or just you on a whole as an artist representing us?
You know what's funny? The funny thing about it is that when I shared that 85 song, I was actually sharing my story. it's something that happens to me. It's not like the makeup something and just come with some fake makeup store. It was real life issues that I had overcome. And like I said before, my album is called Mirror because I'm mirroring all the things that I managed to go through and overcome. And in this song, if you notice, I never call nobody name, I just sing my song, and I talk about my experience, and I show my call, I never call no phone, and people just jump out. But I tell people all the time that that's my story. If somebody should approach me to do a mirror or something, still have a comeback because it still is my story, and still in my past. And I don't think people realize that, apart from the mix-up, that that was like my real story.
Right. Right, and that's what, because I know that's what you know, you had mentioned, of course, in rebuttal to everything, to say that, you know, you're just telling your life experience, so why is it such a big problem? But yeah, like I said, it did create a lot of chaos, but you're always, like, in the media, and this single, you know, bring out the besties, of course, in your defense, to defend Spice all the way. Like, you know, why, you know, music is the art that you use to tell your story, and why is it that you can't do it when it's your own? That, you know, you should be entitled to do so, which you did, and, you know, we appreciate that. But like we said, you know, we know each other for many, many years, and it's a lot of fight that you receive and a lot that you have been through, that the success that you are experiencing right now, I just say, you know, just stay focused. You've got your besties. They're here for you. The love is here. Yeah. And, you know, we want to continue to see you propel and rise the way that you are, because y'all represent us. Like, you are it. You are, you know, our female artist that is representing Jamaica. Like, you know, you speak Jamaica, you say Spice. You get me? It's like you're in the iconic stage. You're the icon stage for Jamaica. Like, you can't say Jamaica without thinking of Spice. And you've made that. You made your name for yourself. And I just want to congratulate you. And as you mentioned, 25 years in the music industry. It's not something easy. And especially
it's
as
not a
female.
Small thing.
No, it's not. It's a big, big deal. And you
it's
did that as a female. So I did want to ask you a question, because I did see recently in the media, one of our athletes, Janelle, that is representing Jamaica, came under scrutiny for the color of her skin, because they're saying that she's too dark skinned. And I know you have been a champion to rally about that.
About colorism. I missed that. Well, you have to send that to me. I didn't see that.
Yes, yes. So they're in her DM, and they're talking about her skin and telling her that she needs to lighten her skin, which is so harsh.
Who are telling her that?
We want black people. Don't want black people, Spice.
Did she come out and speak about it?
Yes, she did. And yes,
what
she made the.
On Google right now.
Yes, Janelle. Let me get her last name. I don't wanna botch it, but yeah, she actually came out, and big shout out to ZJ Sparks, because she came also in her defense, that people is saying that they feel like, you know, she's probably making up the story, but she was able to show proof of the fact her about her
in
complexion.
That room for you.
Yes, yes, yes. So basically what she said is, for all the Jamaican in my inbox coming from my complexion, calling me black is not an insult. This black is gold. And I thought that was the best response that she ever, you know, say when it comes to her black complexion. Because again, they're going after her for her skin tone. So what would you say is your take on that? Being that, you know, you have been rallied and you have experienced it in the music industry, what advice could you have? You could give to Janelle at this moment, because I feel so hurt for her, and I'm like, why is that the focus when she's representing us in the 2024 Olympics at this very moment? It's like, you know, taking off her mental.
It makes me sad that in 2024 that's still happening, because celebrating 25 years, I have been in a similar position where I can say I've walked it, and so I know it. I can speak on it because I know that it's real. I know that colorism is green and it exists because I've been through it. They've said the same things to me, that they don't understand how I have too much money, I'm in a bleach and turn up my skin. Making it seem like if I had a Eurocentric appearance, I would have reached further, which is why I did Black Hypocrisy in 2018 when I made it seem like I had changed the color of my skin, because I wanted to have the world as divided as next time I was talking about colorism, because it's really plaguing the community, the black community. And it's just sad to know that now in 2024, they still don't understand that that is really gold.
Mm-hmm.
I have a song on my album called Mirror, and I love that song so much. And I want to dedicate that song from my Mirror to my album, which is called Mirror, to just ask. I really would like to see the post because I'm going to look for it. Mm-hmm. And remember, me send a seminar for don't read.
Yeah, I'll send it to you without a doubt. I definitely will. But yes,
thank you, sir.
I just want
to encourage her to continue and to use them, see how if they come back around, come congratulate her and ask her if she's hiring. Like, she has to just continue and shame them and let them see that she will use her same black skin and win.
Exactly, I agree 100%. I always say keep doing what you're doing, Janelle. We love you, and just, you know, continue to represent us, Jamaica, because you're making us very, very proud. So big up yourself on that, definitely, Spice. Like I said, I know you're a champion for that, and unfortunately, it's something that is prevalent within our culture. You'd like to see it change, but we say, you know, sometimes people just can't, you know, get with the time and just get to love and unity and love yourself. So, and I love the fact that you have, you know, your album is titled Mirror, so you can actually reflect. And I wanted to ask you this question because I have seen, you know, multiple interviews that you've done. And I see that you are basically calling certain name where you done said alleged, you know, feud may have happened in your past. And I've seen you apologize to, you know, other, like, some media outlets and so on and so forth. And I just wanted to ask, is this, you know, the mirror, obviously, based on your 25 years, is it really you? As them say, you know, Bob Marley say, you know, you look, you have to, I would say Michael Jackson, you have to look back at the man in the mirror. Is this a level of self-growth for you that you're, you know, changing the way how you want to, in terms, react? Because, like I said, it's something hard for any artist to be scrutinized and have so much hate. And I commend you on your strength. But I'm just curious, you know, with this mirror journey, if it's something that is a self-perseverance of changing to a different level for you that you're on.
Absolutely. When I came up with the name Mirror 25 for my album, it was because I've been reflecting. Reflecting on things that I probably was wrong for. Reflecting on things that I've been through. Reflecting on all the hurt, after the pain, why they, you know, stuff like that. So it's like, I am at a place of growth right now where I'm human. I've made mistakes, but it's not never too late to correct them. And I remember back in the past, me used to be this stubborn girl. I mean, I said, we're not chapter this, I'm not chapter that, I'm going to forgive this. These people realize now I'm just at a different space. And I feel like everybody goes through that phase where when you grow, you just get older, so you get wiser. And I just feel like I'm just in that era where I'm not angry anymore, you know? And that was just a part of it. When I did the interview, mm-hmm. I did it because I want to do it. I think a lot of people feel like, oh, she'll come out with her album. No, that's why I should do it. But then I realized that at the same time, it's not a change. If you don't want to talk to him, I'm not going to talk to you.
True.
And nobody can force you to talk to you. PR can't tell you to talk to you. But I, myself, Grace Hamilton, is coming from a place of growth. Mm-hmm. And that's just where I'm at. I'm reflecting on things that I've been through. And I'm just at a better place mentally, physically. And I just want to make sure that when I leave this earth, that, you know, my accolades and everything that I leave here, my legacy, it's the true reflection of who I am. Because sometimes I overreact in a moment. Because let's be very clear, when I went on that interview, I was very open and I let them know why I was so angry at the time.
Mm-hmm.
When I reacted the way I did, because I felt like you were trying to downplay me. My brand, I've been doing this for 25 years by myself. I'm not a manager, I'm not a record label. This is hard work and dedication. This is consistency and commitment. So I'm not one about it. That's why I say, you're not up like me. But the truth is, what you're going to not take away from me is how hard I have worked, the resilience that I've put in and built my brand on my own as a black woman coming out of Jamaica.
Yes.
So when I laid the foundation, I let him know that this is the reason why I felt the way I felt. That was coming from my heart.
Mm-hmm.
But I said, I felt that way at that time,
mm-hmm.
but I've grown now. So I forgive you. And so I want to apologize for acting the way I act. And that's a natural normal something on the body I put on and a second show and I did an interview with Mirror 25. I'm just coming off a Good Morning America when I did this interview.
Right.
So when Mr. People, I say, oh, she comes to fix the cars, what? Like, I was like, make it make sense.
Yes.
Like, literally, I'm doing international press. So I didn't have to do the interview.
Correct.
Any interview we do, I become one, do it. Become like, when them tell about your interview, I want you because you all your support me. It's not like you want to talk to me now because of the mixed up and go on. You've always supported my music. You get what I'm saying?
Right.
So it is what it is.
Right.
So just pick up everybody that has been supporting me for the 25 years. And that's just what my album is all about. It's all about me celebrating 25 years.
And I have to say, like, that is basically what I took from it, that it was just a group, like, you know, you just choosing now to say, all right, I don't have to respond to everyone that have the negativity, but I can help hold myself accountable, and I can say, and it's, you're only human, so it's okay for you to react certain way in certain instances. And that's what I said, it's hard, as you know, we sometimes we have to take off the title and say, yes, you are Dancehall Queen Spice, you are an artist, but you have human, you have feelings. And
yes,
you know, you hurt, you know, you hurt, and you're entitled to react the way that you do. But then, you know, if you self-reflect, it's totally fine. So I said big up to you on that. And I love everything that you're doing right now. And I can't wait to hear the complete album, obviously, which is dropping August the 9th. Again, Radio Land, make sure you go out and cop it, pre-order it right now. And I know that there is a lot that is coming up. You're booked and busy. And I know that there is another event that is coming up next week, Friday. You're going to be performing at, you know, which is a big deal. The Rise Up New York. It's epic. You know, big shout out, of course, to the mayor and everything. So Rise Up New York, the Unity Freedom Concert. Can you tell us, you know, how do you feel about like hitting this stage, which I know that you've been a humanitarian and you're here to help others and uplift others, and you know what your fans could actually expect at this event coming up on
I want them to expect a different spice, a different flavor, a spice that they've never seen before, because I know that people know the type of performance that I bring, that because of the type of show, they just want to know that people come out with them family so they never see what different side of spice. Plus that's the day that my album launched.
Yes.
So you just never come with the fresh song them as well. So just come expecting to have a spicy time as usual, a burst of energy. I'm excited. I know them are gonna leave excited when we're done with them.
Mad. Cause that's what I was saying, you know, we know Grace Hamilton, you know, be coming out when it comes to the West, yes, in a proper event. So
absolutely.
She'll make it a note from right now, you know, you're going to see a different spice that come in, not the dancehall queen to do the breakout, so don't expect all of that, the splits and everything, but do expect, you know, Spice to come with a phenomenal performance for a great event. Again, it's the Rise Up New York Unity Freedom Concert going down in Wingate Park. It's a free event. The doors open at 5 and showtime is actually at 6 p.m. So you just go on out, and that's Brooklyn, New York. So, Spice, you know, speaking about your event, and just to touch on just a little topic, like we said, you know, you have experienced a scrutiny. In one of your performances recently with the Unruly, your fans, because you have performed too at LGBT community events in Canada and all that kind of stuff, and you had a fan that came on stage, and you were receiving backlash for entertaining said bestie. What, since you have, you know, it's your voice, what would you like to say to the people?
No, man, 30 seconds again. We never did a receive the backlash. See a gap. Oh, 30 seconds about it.
Jesus.
No, we never did a receive the backlash.
All right, Mr. Vegas.
Come on, 30 seconds about it.
Yes, so how do you feel?
Bad mind, Vegas, come on, 30 seconds about it. Jealous Vegas, come on, 30 seconds about it.
Yes. So Mr. Vegas did come out, and you know, he's scrutinizing your performance, and then of course you decide to drop the video showing that if the call and I said we're not a transgender, then they must come.
Thank you very much. I can't lie to your man.
Yes, so
how is it like make sense? It's a lot of hypocrisy that is happening with the music. And that's why nobody in my life, if I'm not going to stop, I like it. Because how is it never do a performance? And now my call out people on the stage. You know, you ever seen a performance stop and say, what's your sexual preference? Who you are? I say, I don't do that. Like, come on, make it make sense. So I call up someone and it happens to be somebody that is from the LGBTQ. And what you are telling me, you run them and tell them, I'm coming for the stage, but you have an interview that you did in the past. Saying that when you saw the transgender, let's be very clear, Mr. Vegas, you call them and up them up on the office, no more no less, you up them up on a take picture. So why is this, what is this hypocrisy?
And
trying to assassinate my
career. Mm-hmm. Because you feel like we don't remember your interviews, Mr. Vegas. You're a hypocrite. That's the problem. And it's not just him. I'm so for them jealous to see that me and them come from the same era, but we still are real. Yes. Now I'm not now one to them. But close here, but you never remember that I have a fan base named Best Food. We have all kind of receipt from in the past. So me just remind him to stop your hypocrisy. Because you love transgender. That's what you love them, you love them.
Right. And like many people say, I mean, what were you going to do? You can't run the fan. It's your fan and your fan base is open to everyone.
And I'm not going to. And I just want to be very clear. Mm-hmm. I don't care about anybody what nobody I do. Because I just do music and I'm doing music. I'm doing a... How is it that somebody ever come? The one away there in Jamaica. Mm-hmm. And our aim is to make our impact global. But then you want to dictate who should listen to your music. Like, I mean, you know, the confusion of the hypocrisy, the level of hypocrisy, crazy to me. When Mr. Vegas go anywhere to perform, he don't know who in the crowd.
True.
Let's be very clear.
True. I agree.
So 100%. What are you saying? Like, make it make sense. You're just trying to find a reason to come at me because you are jealous of the level where I'm taking my career. You never expect it. Because to go back to it, you never expected a little black girl to have a couple from Jamaica and start kicking from the door to keep it shut. That's the problem.
And again, because you're like always trending, you feel like a lot of times this is just to get some attention that they're trying to get towards whatever it is that
they're
doing. So
when Mr. Vegas came out and said, I should not be interacting with that person from the LGBTQ community. Mm-hmm. And I posted an interview where he's saying he loved them and he hugged them up and he texted me and asked them more. Mm-hmm. How do you feel?
Like the song Hypocrisy.
Okay, don't talk Black Barbie, because you know you're not media. One plus one or two, and if one goes, I don't want to level. Me don't talk.
Yeah, so of course, you guys hear it. She's saying it loud and clear. And of course, as you guys know, Spice will always speak the truth. She speak what's in her heart. And right is right. And I mean, you know, she just come with her receipts. She just drop it and it just might drop everything. So it's like, oh, all right. Kill that real quick. But I have to say, you know, big up to yourself. Try to just drown out the noise. Again, I know that it's really hard to do, especially on your level. And as you said, you know, staying current for over 25 years and doing it really big is definitely a milestone that we have to commend and congratulate. So congratulations to you. Keep doing your thing. Can't wait for the album to drop. Is there any other projects that you're working on? Because I know that you have your hand in so much stuff. You're an entrepreneur. You have your restaurant. Maybe I saw something like, do you have like a hotel in a one country? Ah, one country?
Yes, everything. Just tell the people them, say, keep your eye on the prize and keep focused. Prayer and hard work conquers all. Don't follow the night. Just focus.
Yes.
Mayor 25 from August 9. Make sure to support the Queen the real way. Buy the album on iTunes or Amazon. Don't listen to Apple Music alone and not stream it for free. Mm-hmm. You got to do real support by buying the album.
Yes. I remember August 9th. Make sure that you definitely go and get it. So Spice, big shout out to you. Thank you so much for taking the time out to do this interview again. I wish you nothing but the best. I don't know, so support from long time and continue to support you through all your entire music career. Cause we say one love, we're the Leo. My Leo sis, I love you. Happy birthday
love
when
you.
It comes.
You got yourself. Thank you so much.
You are so welcome. But before you leave us, I'd love for you to actually introduce one of your tracks off the album, Mirror 25, with the bro, Mr. Busted Rhymes, for Radioland right now.
This one is called Wrong, featuring the boss man, the legend, Busta Rhymes. Make sure when you're here, anyway, you're able to pull over and drive because you have to dance right now and just go round and round.